expert Mike Kelly, who I gotta say is rocking a very fresh holiday suit. Sir, let's start there. Break it down for us.
Well, we got a little bit of red. We got a little bit of white, naturally. You don't have to adjust the colors in your TV set. It is this ugly. A little snowman on the tie. The tie actually plays music, too. I'll spare you that. But,
please don't spare us. Play it. Yeah. Play
it's,
it.
It's holiday party season, so a little jingle bells. There you go. So I thought I'd throw the jacket on and you know, you guys were talking about the baby blue suits earlier. I thought, I got to one up these guys.
You, and you, sir, you did exactly that. I love it. I hope you're going to be rocking that to some holiday parties because the tie alone is a conversation piece. but let's talk some hockey now, shall we? Let's start with the headline of the day, Carter Hart winning in his NHL debut last night with Philly. Analytically, how impressive was his performance?
Well, his performance was impressive, but so was the performance of his teammates. That's where we got to give some hats off to as well. I mean, what a moment for Carter Hart. This guy is hopefully the future in net for the Philadelphia Flyers. They've already had five goalies go this year. Look at what the team did defensively, though. On average this season, they allow 14 shots from the house per game. Against Detroit, they cut that number in half. That helps Carter Hart in his debut. Let's go to the real high danger area on the ice, the inner slot. Half the goals in the league are scored from here. They average 7 against per game, just 3 against the Detroit Red Wings. The team defense in front of Carter Hart definitely helped this kid in his first game of the season here, his first game with the Philadelphia Flyers. And yeah, he also played really well. So again, they've used 5 other goalies this year. This was the 6th goalie of the season in their first 35 games. That's an NHL record. Philly's hoping over the long haul this is the guy for them. And talking to a former goalie today, a former goalie coach, brought up the names Braden Holtby, Carey Price as guys who have the same technical kind of makeup as what he sees in Carter Hart. So big compliments there and a great moment too, seeing his mom crying and the whole thing with that. So awesome debut for Carter Hart.
Yes, a wonderful story, and Flyers fans are very happy to have Carter Hart on the team. Mike, I got to be honest, I get tweeted about Alex Barkov all the time. I want to say almost every single day, Monday to Friday. He's drawn a league-best 25 penalties on the year. What makes that number so impressive?
Oh, the number itself's impressive. I'm glad people are tweeting you because
they are. They're always like, talk more about Barkov, more about Barkov.
Exactly. And for too long, I think, you know, he hasn't been talked about enough. I think you're right, though. He's starting to get the love. You look at the penalties drawn more than anybody. He's taken 0 penalties. And this is what impresses me the most. He has the most active defensive stick of any forward in the NHL. Leads all forwards in stick checks, leads all forwards in block passes in the defensive zone, breaking up plays. And he plays more than any other forward. He plays more than anyone on his team, defensemen included. You look at everything that's on that list. Alex Barkov is a superstar. And we'll show a couple of plays here. He goes into the corner here. Here comes a nice stick check as he's able to get the puck, separate it from his opponent. And it ends up going to a teammate into the back of the net. Alex Barkov in his defensive zone as well. Very active. We talked about the defensive pass blocks that he has. Here's a player in front of the net. He's down low. He's able to get a stick on this pass from Claude Giroux into the middle of the ice. Breaks the puck up ice. And it ends up with a Florida Panther goal. And we have another example as well. Where Alex Barkov, a stick check in the defensive zone. And again, the Panthers right there. Panthers break it up ice and go in and score a goal. So what impresses me, you talk about the 25 drawn penalties and the none taken and what that adds in terms of having extra power play goals and not having to kill penalties. But it's the fact that he has the most active defensive stick of any forward in the league. You put those two things together, that's the Selke trophy. I don't care what his plus minus is. I don't care where the team finishes. And that's the Lady Bing trophy. So I'll see you in Vegas, probably not wearing the suit, Alex Barkov.
Let's hope not, but maybe an even better suit, maybe an awards themed suit. But yes, Barkov, a superstar with a capital S. He is so good, as are Mikko Rantanen and Nathan MacKinnon, the two headliners in Colorado. Just how understated, though, is the third member of that line, Gabe Landeskog?
I think so. It's, again, you know, Rantanen and MacKinnon, the only guys with more than 50 points this year. What about Gabe the Babe Landeskog? This guy's on fire. He's 4th in the league in goals. He's got 22. He is a presence in front of the net, deflects a lot of shots. He's got more deflection goals than anyone else in the National Hockey League, and he breaks up plays, good defensive stick, good on the other side of the puck in the neutral zone, 4th amongst forwards in terms of breaking up those plays, sending it back the other way to create more offense for his line mates. Look at the goal that he scored in the last game against the Islanders in front of the net, a nice deflection. He, to me, is the guy that stirs the drink for this line. McKinnon, so much raw ability, speed, such a presence. Mikko Rantanen, a great playmaker, great vision, great passing. Gabe Landeskog, do not sleep on this guy and how good he's been. Again, he's top five in the NHL in goals. And I know we've got all-star voting going on right now at NHL.com, and McKinnon and Rantanen are almost surely going to be there. Getting three guys from a team might be tough, but what do you do if Gabe Landeskog's top five, top three in the league in goals? I think, you know, he's the captain, obviously, for a reason, a terrific young player, but we always talk about the duo. It really is a trio with Gabe Landeskog.
We've talked about a lot of superstars during this conversation, but I think the stud of this particular segment is your holiday time. Mike, will you take us to break by just playing the jingle again?
All right, my pleasure. No copyright on this one. There you go.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Mike Kelly.